In this lecture, we're going to look at how solutions to equations and inequalities in two variables look like. So remember in the last module, when we solved equations or inequalities in one variable, the solution could be represented either as points on a number line or infinitely many points as intervals on number line. So when we are plotting solutions to equations and inequalities in two variables, the result is either a curve or a region bounded by these curves in the xy plane. In this module, we'll investigate equations that represent lines, circles, and a few other types of curves and specific regions that are bounded by these curves. The idea of describing geometric curves with algebraic equations is called analytic geometry. I can tell you for myself as a student, I really was drawn to mathematics precisely because of analytic geometry. I was so amazed that equations could be thought of as these beautiful curves that you are about to see. All right, so let's take a look at how we can play with some of these equations. A crude tool that is available to you right now in order to figure out how something looks like is to plot as many solution points to the equation as you need so you can see a pattern emerge. There are many other sophisticated tools that you'll see in college algebra, calculus, that give you other methods of curve sketching. So let's start with testing points in the xy plane to see if they are solutions to a given equation or inequality or not. So in order for a point in an xy plane, a comma b, remember this is the x coordinate, this is the y coordinate, to be a solution to an equation or an inequality is if we replace a for x and b for y in the equation and you end up with a true statement, then the point a, b is a solution to that equation or inequality. Let's take some concrete examples. So we are asking you, are these points, the four points listed here, solutions to this equation y equals x minus 1? So let's make a table because that'll make it easy for us to see. So we have our equation, which is y equals x minus 1. Our point, let's start with the first point, negative 2, 1. This negative 2 is the value of x coordinate, 1 is the value of y coordinate. So we substitute that in this equation, and we'll end up with 1 equals negative 2 minus 1, or 1 equals negative 3, which is a false statement. So false statement, what that means is that negative 2 comma 1 is not a solution to this equation. If it were, you should get a true statement. All right, pause the video here and do this next point on your own. And then we'll discuss it. Go ahead, pause it. All right, so you replace x equals 2 and y equals 1, and look what we get. We get 1 equals 1, which is a true statement, and that means 2, 1 is a solution to our equation y equals x minus 1. All right, try the next two points on your own, pause the video, and then we'll discuss it. Assuming you've paused the video and you've come back, so let's do the next two. So x is negative 5 and y is 0. Plug it in and you get 0 equals negative 6, which is a false statement. So negative 5, 0 is not a solution. 0, negative 1, negative 1 equals 0 minus 1, negative 1 equals negative 1. So true. So 0, negative 1 is a solution to the equation y equals x minus 1. So it's relatively easy to check whether a given point is a solution to this equation or not. Okay, let's try inequality. Again, same thing. You're going to make a chart, substitute the point negative 2 for x, 1 for y, and we get 1 is greater than negative 5, which is a true statement. So negative 2, 1 is a solution to y greater than 2x minus 1 inequality. However, look, So is any point negative 2y as long as the y would be greater than negative 5. Because if you put a y here and you end up with y greater than negative 5. So as long as your y coordinate is bigger than negative 5, could be 1, could be negative 1, 100. So negative 2, comma, any y coordinate that is bigger than negative 5 is going to be a solution to this inequality. So there are infinitely many solutions to this inequality. All right, you try the point 2, 3, negative 5, 0, and 4, negative 1, and see if they are solutions to this inequality. Pause the video here, please. Assuming you have paused the video and you've come back, I'll share the solutions with you here. All right, so 2, 3, you plug it in. You get 3 is bigger than 3, which is false. So 2, 3 is not a solution. When you plug in negative 5, 0, 0 greater than negative 11 is a true statement. So negative 5, 0 is a solution. And in fact, as long as you use any y coordinate bigger than negative 11, negative 5, y, where y is bigger than negative 1, are all solutions to this inequality. So negative 5, negative 10, negative 9, 100, any y coordinate, as long as x is negative 5 and y is bigger than negative 1, are all solutions to this inequality. What about 4, negative 1? We get negative 1 bigger than 7, which is a false statement. So 4, negative 1 is not a solution. All right, let's take a look at what if we give you y equals 2x minus 1 is our equation, and we only give you one of the coordinates. Can you find a missing coordinate? So let's try these problems and see what you can do. Again, make a chart similar to the one we were just looking at, and that will help you. So pause the video and try on your own first. All right, so we have negative 2, y, x is negative 2, and y coordinate is y coordinate. So you plug it in, x equals negative 2, solve for y, and you get y equals negative 5. What that means is that if you want x to be the negative 2, x is fixed, x is negative 2, then y coordinate will have to be negative 5. So negative 2, negative 5 is a solution to this equation. If you wanted x, 3, which means what x coordinate can we have so that when y coordinate is 3, this point is a solution to the equation. So you plug in x, you plug in 3 for y, solve for x, and look what we get. We get x equals 2. So 2, 3 is a solution. Again, if you do 0, y, so you're replacing x to 0 and solving for y, you end up with y equals negative 1. Such a coordinate, when x coordinate is 0, is called the y-intercept, because if you were to plot it, it will be on the y-axis. When the y-coordinate is 0, this point is called the x-intercept, because when you plot it, this point is going to be on the x-axis. So plug in y equals 0, solve for x, you get x equals 1/2. So that's how you find missing coordinates. We are doing this exercise because that's how you decide what points are solutions to an equation. You pick any coordinate, solve for the remaining variable, and you are now ready to plot points. You can do the same for inequalities. So again, let's do the same thing. So you can solve for y and you get y greater than 3. That means 2 comma y, where y is bigger than 3, are all solutions to this inequality. So like 4, 3.1, 5.1, could be 2 comma any y coordinate, as long as it's bigger than 3, you'll have a solution. Same process when you have y coordinate is negative 1 and you want to find x. So 0 greater than x, which means x has to be smaller than 0 when you solve. So any coordinate for which x coordinate is smaller than 0 is going to work with you as long as the y coordinate is negative 1. So negative 4, negative 1, negative 1, negative 1, and so on. All right, so what happens here? Then say y is bigger than negative 1. So 0 is the x coordinate fixed. Y coordinate has to be any coordinate as long as it's bigger than negative 1. So like 0, 1, 2, 1.1, 4.5, 5, all of those will form solutions to this inequality. Let's do x0. Again, replace y to 0, solve for x. So x is smaller than 1 half. So you can have 0, you can have negative 1, and so on. So these are all solutions to the inequality when y coordinate is 0.